Start laughing. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Motovloggers Anonymous. Today's a special edition. It is Thirsty Thursday, meaning we're all drinking. And by we're all drinking, it's probably just me, so.
I don't have mine yet.
Oh, no, this happens every time. Every time I start the chat, my side chat, Linyu starts playing as well. So we got Miss Battleborn Rider in the hangout tonight. What's going on, Miss?
Hola.
Hola.
Doing well.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Bien usted.
I know some Spanish, por favor. uno más cerveza, please.
That's the only one you need to worry about.
We got Mr. Split Eye. What's going on, Split?
What's going on, man?
We had K-Dub. We now just have a K-Dub logo in the chat. So everybody
He went somewhere.
Yeah, he's somewhere. He's having mic issues, but that's okay. He'll fix it. He'll get it all sorted out. So how the hell has everybody been?
Pretty good. How about you?
Yeah, good.
I have been just running rampant. I've been working like crazy the last couple of weeks, and I just had no time. I have been so like deactivated from social life. No Instagram, no Twitter, barely any YouTube. I'm so disconnected. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah. Well, end of season, I guess it's just kind of you get out of the whole model vlogging style a little bit.
Honestly, it's just work. Work's been keeping me so damn busy that I just don't have time for anything. No excuses to my subs, though. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to all of you. K-Dub, we get K-Dub back in the chat? Did he make it? I don't know.
I don't know.
Probably not.
Am I here now?
Hey! We have
hey,
a voice
there.
You've made it, sir. You've made it to the chat. Welcome. I am having one hell of a time trying to get the side chat back.
Why is it busted?
Oh, you just did
I'm having
a
hell of a time trying to connect to this Canadian server tonight.
Hey, don't blame the Canadian servers, okay? New York fucking put us under like 10 years ago for 3 days. Fuck you. Everybody remembers that one.
Oh my gosh, that was like 2004.
Yeah, 10 years ago, 11 years ago. That's crazy. I wasn't in the province for that, though, so I didn't get any of the fun. I didn't get the loot or, you know.
I was on the way to the movie theater, and then it happened, and I was just like,
I'll
watch the movie tomorrow, and then, nope, 3 days.
No, yeah, no.
I didn't hear you.
That?
Oh, what movie were you going to see? That's the true test.
What'd you say?
What movie were you going to see?
Thank you, Battleborn.
I guess you can't hear
you. It's not working. Fuck.
Is it not working? All right, so K-Dub has no mic. Split Eye has no sound.
I'm here. I just have it muted. I'm accelerating.
He's accelerating. Well, let's hear that VTech.
Oh, fuck. The movie?
That's not VTech. That's K-Tech.
K-Tech. That's copyrighted from now on.
It's copyrighted. Shit, son. Why you gotta do that? Split, can you hear me now?
Good.
Good. Ah, damn it.
Uh-oh, did he get pulled over by the cops?
No, she beat me to it. Thanks.
Yeah.
Good. Like the Verizon guy.
Yeah, you like
now?
Good.
Oh! That's a win over my head. That's a good one. Yeah, we don't get those commercials too much up here.
I had to do it.
We have a fucking monopoly. Bell owns everything up here. So, nothing we can do. Like, even the competing companies that compete with, like, our top phone company are owned by our top phone company. So, what is this chat is going through all sorts of issues right now.
It is.
So, I am sad to say that Miss Battleborn down in Reno is, she has some snow today.
Yeah, it's supposed to snow.
Yeah?
Let's check it out.
I am back.
pretty bad when Reno gets snow and like people, like everybody I know that lives in Toronto is out riding right now, except for me, of course. But
I was bitching so much last week about like 30 degree weather, and today it was like 85 or 86. It was amazing.
That's crazy. That seems like it's 20 some degrees. Like, that's pretty hot.
Yeah, it's pretty warm. That was better than, or more than I liked. Like, I like perfect 75, 76.
80 is
today,
really
I was sweating my ass off.
For us, I don't know what it converts to. I can't think real quick. But for me, like, perfect riding weather is, like, 20 degrees. And I think Split Eye can agree with me on that. Because it's, like, it's cold enough to wear leathers, but warm enough where you're comfortable.
See.
I was riding today. I mean, I was comfortable in that, so.
Were you? Yeah, but today's nice. Today's what? 8 degrees today?
Yeah, it was like 8, I guess, yeah.
Oh, so like, I think around 60, 70 degrees, I think I'm getting. Hold on.
Well, I mean, if you're going on the highway, it would suck, because it would be like pretty windy and cold, but if you stay on like those country roads, 8 degrees isn't that bad.
Yeah, I guess.
So you're saying 20 degrees Celsius is like 68 here, converted. That's pretty nice.
I use Siri for my American conversion.
What? 20 degrees Celsius is 68?
That's what I'm getting.
No. Really? What?
That's what I was getting here. Hold on. Because that's what I was getting just here.
What is 20 degrees Celsius in Fahrenheit?
It's 68 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yep.
What did I tell you?
Oh, so what is 85 degrees Fahrenheit in Celsius? That's what it was today.
What is 85 degrees Fahrenheit in Celsius?
29.4 degrees.
Oh my god, that is freaking amazing.
Yeah, that's what it was today.
That's fucking beach weather, man. I'd be riding to the beach.
That's what I was saying. I was sweating my ass off after about the first hour. Like, it got to me. Because it's been so cold, so I've been bundling up.
Like, what's your average temperature for this year?
For, like, right now? Mm-hmm. Or for the year?
Now?
Like, are you talking about, like, the average for December?
Yeah, I guess. Like, what are you talking about?
It's, like, normally, like, in the 50s or 60s, so.
Nice.
Which, last week was weird because it was really fucking cold for us. And this week's weird because it's been really hot for this time of year.
Yeah, it's been extremely hot. Like, I just saw, like, you know how Facebook has that, the memories thing? You can look back on what you've posted. Fucking look back at your life or whatever.
Yeah, the
Last year we had snow. Yeah, exactly. Last year we had snow. 2 years ago I was snowboarding. 3 years ago I was snowed in. Like, I'm just like, oh my god. This year I'm riding still.
It's odd weather.
It just shows me us as like a human race, our planet, we're progressively getting worse. Like, it's just temperatures are rising and rising, and we're solving.
K-Dub, I've got driving moccasins here. He wants to say that he said hi. So, he says hi.
who's this now? Driving
moccasins? Oh, driving moccasins? Yeah, I gave him a little shout-out on Instagram. That dude, you guys, if y'all haven't seen his fucking intro, you got to go check his channel out. Like, this dude has probably the coolest fucking intro ever. Like, definitely check him out.
Yeah,
post his name up in the chat.
He's got the bench warmers thing on too that he invited me as well. So
that's tonight too, huh?
Yeah, that's tonight.
I forgot about that one.
I follow him on Instagram. Yeah. He's doing that now, isn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a shit.
Yeah. Dude, there's so many hangouts going on tonight.
I know. That's a shit.
There's a few.
I'll give him a shout out on my channel. What's up, buddy? I have to check him out. I think I got him on Instagram.
Meh.
Goats here.
Mr. Goatfather. Is he having mic issues too? Son of a bitch. We'll just pretend he didn't join the chat.
Yeah. We all said hi, and then it's like, oh, he's not here.
It's probably for the best.
Oh, there he is.
My man, how you doing, Goat?
How's it going, guys?
It's going good. I haven't done a hangout in a while. I feel off. I don't know what I'm doing. I also haven't shaved in a while. You should, like, take care of that. That's when the cricket sounds comes in.
I should bring him up, right?
Exactly. Where's Steve Light when you need him?
Where is Steve? I mean, he definitely can't be riding. He let his license expire, so...
Yeah, that's what he said. I don't know. I messaged him, but I think he's probably sleeping or, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, doing his thing.
That guy's on Twitch 24/7.
Yeah, well, he used to be a professional gamer, so you can never really fully get rid of that.
How do you become... What's a professional gamer? You know, when somebody says professional gamer to me, I feel like... They're that person that was playing, like, Mario in front of, like, a crowd. Like, what was that movie? Anybody remember that movie? Where, like, they had, like, a Nintendo battle?
I know what you're talking about, but I can't recall the movie.
I can't remember the name of the movie, but it was, like, totally, like, 80s or 90s movie.
Mm-hmm. And, like, I do. Like, love.
Super Mario in, like, 30 seconds or something. I don't know. That's what... Maybe Will would know. Will would know.
In the side I do chat. Remember, like, there was, like, the movie Hackers where they had, like... They played.
Yeah,
like,
that's movie. What I was thinking of.
I was thinking of that movie, but I don't think I know what you're talking about.
When did that movie come out?
Like 1994.
Yeah, it's old.
That could probably be it. Maybe I'd have to.
It was like it was with Angelina Jolie though, so I feel like you would remember.
No, definitely not the right movie. No, yeah. I'll think of a different one then.
Yeah, that's what I thought. But they did have a similar thing in that movie, so.
So, Split, I heard you just did a drift stitch on your bike.
Yeah, it was pretty sweet. I saw Chris Fix do a video on that Mustang where it was, like, all split down the center of that fender, and it looked really sweet afterwards, and I was like, I should do that on the bike, because when I bought the bike, it had, like, I think two or three cracks in the fairings. Yeah. So, yeah. Yeah, it turned out pretty good.
Nice.
Yeah, I got the pictures on Instagram.
I used to do that on my the front lip of my drift car.
Yeah, you told me you have a Toyota. What was it?
I had an older Toyota. That was my street car. But I had a I had a 240 SX. Was my
really?
Drift car. Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's proper drift car.
Yeah, that's proper drift stitch.
That's drifting pedigree right there, 240SX.
That's like the intro to drifting, just by that.
Yeah, those and like the S15 Silvias and all that other stuff.
Whoa,
right?
I didn't have money, dude.
Hey guys, I'm gonna have to hop out for a few minutes, and I'll be back in about 30 minutes or so.
All right,
no worries, man.
All right.
I feel like K-Dub has to go bust somebody. I think he works security.
Yeah,
he's gonna go bust some
there's some unruly people at the front entrance. Go handle them. I'll be back in 30 minutes.
So, Mr. Goatfather, how's life been going for you?
Wonderful.
I heard you guys got some snow just recently, Battleborn was saying. Or you're getting snow, excuse me.
Oh, I don't know. I mean... It could snow in one part of Reno and not in another, so...
That's true.
Really? How far apart are you guys without actually telling you where you live?
Carrie, you guys live down towards, like, Southtown, right?
Correct.
Yeah, so we're about 30 minutes? I'd say, like, 30 minutes?
Yeah.
From each other? Yeah, I live up in...
That's not bad. That would be, like... I guess that would be, like, the actual distance between me and Split Eye right now.
Yeah.
We're about 30 minutes away. You're West End, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
So we've
talked about that before. Yeah. I think you said you're down closer to like the Toronto eastern end of Mississauga, right?
Yeah, I'm Mimico, Lakeshore on Mimico.
Yeah.
You're in the How do I say this without like saying?
I'm like just like north of Port Credit, I guess.
Yeah,
north.
Ish.
Yeah.
Something like
yeah.
That. Ish.
Mm-hmm.
Whoops.
I don't really care. I don't have valuable bikes or anything anyway, so.
Oh man! Somebody stole my fucking office chair. Oh man. Okay, so who's excited for fucking Star Wars? Please tell me one of you guys are as big as a geek as I am.
What's Star Wars?
Uh-huh.
Is it like a motorcycle thing coming up?
Yeah.
What do you think of the Jar Jar Binks fan theory then?
I don't listen to that fucking rubbish.
Oh, okay. I thought it was pretty interesting. I was like, it's probably not true, but I mean, whatever. Like, it sounds pretty cool.
Is everybody else just laughing in this chat right now? It's like, these fucking nerds talking about Star Wars. Okay. I'll definitely say I didn't buy advance tickets, and I'm not going next Thursday at 10:30.
Yeah. No, I'll wait till it comes out on DVD or whatever.
What? How could you wait that long?
Because I'm not that crazy about it. Just not crazy about it.
I'll see it in theaters. It's just after the crowd dies down. I don't feel like being shoulder to shoulder with somebody on that.
Yeah.
No thanks.
Go to a nice little old town theater where the screen's like 40 years fucking old and they don't even have chairs for you to sit in. That's what I'm looking forward to.
There you go.
I got like one of the newer theaters where you get like to pick your seats. It's like VIP seating. So like when you buy your movie ticket, you get to pick what seat you sit in. So your ticket has like a seat number.
Goat, I thought those didn't really exist anymore because I thought they all had to transfer over to like the digital systems now.
No, they're still old town theaters. There's quite a few in Reno. Like
that's really interesting because like we had a drive-in near my parents' place, and they shut down because they couldn't afford to do the conversion for like moving to like HD screens and stuff. And so, like, a big company bought out this place and did the conversion because apparently they couldn't buy movies anymore in the format that they were using for, like, the last 40 years. I don't know. I wonder how those other ones operate then.
I don't know. I don't own a theater, so I couldn't tell you. I just know that they still exist.
Yeah.
That's weird.
I mean, very similar to, like, McMenamin's, which is a huge private theater-ish company all over, like, the Northwest and stuff. I don't know if you guys ever heard of that.
No.
So McMenamin's is kind of like your old stylist type of theater where they still play on smaller screens and stuff like that, but you get to sit in, like, regular chairs, and you can drink alcohol and all that kind of stuff, eat dinner in the theater and all that good stuff.
Yeah, we just got those. They're called VIP theaters. We just got them.
Yeah.
Not like a waitress. You can, like, order food and alcohol, but you pay a lot of money for it.
Hmm. Yeah, I encourage anybody who has never been to McMenamin's to definitely check one out if you live in the States and you're close to the Northwest and stuff.
Nice.
GoFather, sponsored by McMenamin's.
Yeah.
No, right now I'm sponsored by Canada Dry, so.
Canada Dry.
That humors me. Fucking love Canada Dry.
Yeah, dude, me too.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, but I was just saying before, the last couple of weeks I've been working, like this is such a busy time for me with work, and especially since all the nice weather we've been, it's kind of like a double-edged sword, I guess you'd say. It's so nice outside that I can just go riding every day, but at the same time, it's so nice out, I gotta work. So I work construction, I work outside, so it's all kind of weather-dependent. So it just, I've been so fucking busy the last few weeks.
Workflow, though.
What's that?
It's just like that workflow, though.
Yeah, that work life, let me tell you. Getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning sucks. Popping that champagne bottle in the middle of the movie is epic. Mr. Will Moto, linking up the chat for us tonight.
Yay. See, I got it.
Oh, we got a new Steve in the house.
I found him.
So, where's Mr. Mario? Where's your better half?
Oh, he'll be around here soon.
Yeah?
He's out and about.
Did he go to the Canadian beer store?
Yeah, he's going to get some, that's what he told me, and go pick up some mail and everything else.
Right, he's going to get some Canadian beer. So, Go, I see you've released another challenge video. I just watched it the other day. I've been trying to catch up.
Yeah.
That's awesome, man. I love that you're doing that.
Yeah, it's a little more complicated than the last one. So.
I did see that, yeah. Your last one was just... your first one was pick a random motovlogger that you don't know.
Yeah, and go watch their videos.
And go watch the videos and then vlog about them, right?
Yeah.
So what's your second one?
This one is pick any motovlogger Well, this one is share the video, which is easy. Most people, if they like the video, it automatically shares to, like, Twitter or something.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think the second part of the challenge is make a video for yourself, an end-of-year video, video summarizing this year of motovlogging for you. And if applicable, add in there aspects of the community that impacted you in some way. And then write a letter to a fellow motovlogger or viewer slash subscriber and send it to them. So this one's a little more hands-on because I was thinking about it and I was like, well, you know, if I tell people to go out there and watch somebody's video, there's no way to tell if they really did. You know what I mean? And if they really gave a shit, which I think the people who participated, they honestly did and they gave a shit. But I wanted to make it more hands-on to where, I mean, it's the holiday season, right? And yeah. Who wouldn't love to get a random fucking letter from somebody, you know?
That'd be awesome.
Just out of nowhere. So that's why I was like, you know, maybe I could get people, encourage them, if they didn't even think about it this year, to make a end-of-year video for themselves, you know? They're making something for themselves for fun, the topic, and then write a letter to somebody, and then bam, they have a chance at winning a little motorcycle that I spent $20 on. So we'll see what happens. Yeah. If nobody wins, then it stays on my desk, and we move on to the next bike.
There you go. Yeah, that's pretty good. Like I like that. I did a little something like that, like my motovlogger challenge, and I just thought it was cool that I could, like, one motovlogger could connect to another motovlogger via YouTube. I just thought that aspect was pretty cool. But now, like, you're taking it to the next level. Like, you're getting so, like, intricate in it. So that's pretty cool.
Well, I always have. I mean, the Mototalk series is very intricate, but it kind of got fucking shit all over with all the fucking drama that got attached to it. But before that, I mean, if you search Mototalks, you've got almost 1,000 fucking Mototalks videos out there, and it's all communal-based. So I was just looking at a way to encourage people to interact with each other, and the only way that you can seem to do it is to pay them, basically. So hence the chance to win the motorcycles.
Yeah. Well, it's always a good thing. Everybody wants to be involved, and unfortunately in today's day and age, being involved means getting something in return. You know? So you have to roll with it a little bit. True.
True.
So I worked a double today, so I feel like I'm not going to work tomorrow, so I'm going to be drinking a lot of these tonight. Just a heads up.
Marketing Nation.
Yeah. So, Miss Battleboard, do you want to wait till Mario gets here? Because you know what I'm going to ask.
Ask about your shirt?
Yeah.
Do you want me to go get it?
I do.
Okay, hold on.
So, they got my Teespring shirt, which is so fucking awesome. And it pisses me off because I haven't even received mine yet.
Yeah, I'm playing the game on Sunday. There's really not a whole lot to it.
My phone just started doing stuff. Good thing that wasn't porn. That would have been awkward.
Alright. Oh. I thought he took it with him, and then I found it. So. Okay. There it is. Yeah. See? It's really dark, but do you see it?
Fuck yeah. That is awesome. How do I present you to everybody?
I guess you, I don't know, click on my screen. I'm not sure.
Just click the screen? Yeah, fair enough.
Do you see it?
I see it.
You got the 3K club shirt, eh?
Yeah.
everybody's like, what is that? Is that a shirt? What is
that? Well, I got the mail, and Mario's like, oh, I got you got A Nation's 3 club shirt in. Yeah, I don't know. He might be wearing it when he comes here.
He better fucking return it.
It's return a big shirt.
Oh, that's too funny. So you guys want to answer some questions? I got some questions saved up for the last couple of weeks.
Sure, why not?
Shoot.
Let's do some questions. So, if I can just find them again, because I had them all written down here on my phone. Like I said, I've been so inactive in the last little bit, but I have been saving everybody's requests. Okay, question from, can't read your username, Miss Jackson. Outside of your usual style of bike, what bike would you choose from?
I'm sorry, Miss Jackson. Ooh. I'm for real.
Good one, yeah.
I couldn't stop thinking about that one. I heard.
Yeah, no. As soon as I read that, I was thinking about that.
I'm sorry, Miss Jackson.
So, outside of what you would want to ride. And I'm assuming most of us here ride sport, all of us here ride sports bikes.
Yeah.
I'm just Super trying to think how the bike classifies as a sport bike.
Or a sport I got a 10-speed.
Was that a 10-speed bike?
Yeah.
Does it have a bell on it?
No, I should probably get one.
You should.
That way cars could hear me coming. I could ding, 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 you know.
You should get one of the horns like D Motovloggers has.
And get a card in the wheel.
Oh, that's a good flashback. Thank you, Spudai.
No worries.
So, yeah, the question is, outside of the bike that you would like to have, what bike would you get?
Everything. If money wasn't an issue, I would buy every fucking type of bike I could. That's my answer.
I would definitely try them all, yeah, if I had the money to do that, yeah. But if I had to pick another one that I'd move on to, if it couldn't be the type I was already riding, I'd say Supermoto, because it's a weird style of bike. It feels so different than sport bikes.
Yeah. Supermotos are pretty fucking fun. I've ridden one twice now in the last few months, and every time you get on one, you just want to be like, oh, I want to run over this curb, or I want to go up on the grass. Like, they're just so much fun.
Yeah, it would remind me of every time I've been in, like, a four-wheeler, and I'm just like, yeah, I'm going to go over the center median and make a U-turn that way. So I just, like, go over the curb.
Miss Battleborn?
Just any, like, I would want one of each, at least.
We would want one of each bike.
Yeah, why not?
Y'all some greedy motherfuckers.
No, I'm serious. I'm serious. You can't tell me you wouldn't want one of each. Like, one day you'd be like, okay, I want to ride my Super Sport, and then the next day you're like, oh, I want to ride a Supermoto.
Yeah, fair enough. It kind of cheats the question, though.
That's why I answered it as Supermoto.
I would want a Harley Davidson.
Oh, wow.
I would just want this big-ass cruiser bike. Why not? Just like, I would want like one with like a cappuccino maker and like a 6-CD changer. Surround sound. I would be that guy.
Yeah, man. Those bikes come with speaker systems. I forgot. They have radios and shit on that.
I feel like you can put it on, like, autopilot, like, auto ride, and just, like, take a nap. As the chat wants to eject me from that answer.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
Of course, Will would say that.
Yeah, having said that, I still wouldn't give up my super sport. I would just also have this other lazy sport. That's what we're going to call them from now on, lazy sports.
You got another question there?
I got lots of questions, yeah. I think we had one from the chat, but I'll get to that one after.
Roll out another one.
Got another question here from I can't pronounce these names. What's a good, cheap motorcycle jacket? So I guess we can elaborate, like, motorcycle gear in general.
Sorry. I kind of went overboard there.
Your skin.
What did you say?
I said your skin because there's no such thing as a cheap motorcycle jacket.
Fair enough. No, that, you know what? That brings up a good point. Don't cheap out on motorcycle gear. Because if you're going to go out and you're going to buy that, like, you know, knockoff, no name, $50 jacket, the first time, you know, you actually have to use it, it isn't going to work so well.
Right.
I
would say, to answer the question for myself, best bang for your buck would either be Icon or Alpine Star.
I say Alpine.
Yeah, because you can usually find those relatively cheap, and they're stylish, and they work. They do the job.
Just shop around. If you and then look up the brand. And if there's good reviews on the brand or something, then go for it. Why not?
Yeah,
so do your research on it.
Yeah, just do some research. Because, like, there's always going to be, like, a promotion or a sale on something, like, every so often, like, every couple of months or something, right? Yep. Especially off-season.
No, absolutely, yeah.
I say go to, if you guys have whoever's asking the question, if you have a motorcycle gear store or dealership where you are, go try gear on. That's more important than finding gear that has the best reviews, because you need to make sure it fits to you properly. Otherwise, you're wasting your money.
Yeah. Well, fair enough. Also, like, me and Goat could buy the exact same jackets, and it fits me better than it would fit him.
Exactly.
The other thing too is like
protect me better than it will protect him.
You could also to add on a goat's point of going to a store, check out like a local forums and ask like where's a good place to go, because sometimes some stores have better stock than others, and like I know around here in the GTA we have GTA motorcycles, and a lot of people talk shit about what's that one place in Saga, and they're like, don't go there. Go. Yeah, Rider's Choice. A lot of people really don't like that place. And so it's good to know where to go and where to avoid, I guess, too.
Well, the reason people don't like Rider's Choice is because they're fucking expensive and they rip you off.
That's what I mean, yeah. You don't want to go in to a store and try on all the jackets and then say, oh, yeah, this is a good one, and then it's $800 and it's way too much because they priced it.
Oh.
Yeah, absolutely. Gear, honestly, like, there's no need to go out and spend $900 on a helmet, $700 on a jacket, $500 on boots. Like, you don't need to. Most of the time, you're paying for a name. But having said that, you don't go out and spend $50 on this and $50 on that. Like, you want something in the middle. So it's going to be cost efficient, and also it's going to protect you.
You guys ever seen that, there's this one Russian guy, he takes a Chinese-made helmet and then, like, a Japanese-made helmet, and he smashes the Chinese one with a sledgehammer, and it cracks straight in half. I think it was a sledge or an axe. It was probably an axe, because it cracked in half. And then he takes the Japanese one, and it's like, he can't split it open, and he's like, this is why you don't buy Chinese helmets, like the knockoff helmets, because, like, you get in an accident, it's just going to crack right open.
Yeah, seriously. All right, I'm gonna get Goat to take the lead on this question here, because I'm a little lost on that.
All right, so Ninja Basics, he asked, do any of you guys have one of the Guardian bells or Gremlin protection bells on your bikes? And I just wrote in our private side chat the nutshell of the story behind the Gremlin bell. Yeah. And I would say I have one. It's on my rear brake lever, or like down at the bottom, you know. And it's in some of my pictures, I think. I think somebody pointed out to me, but I can't remember who actually realized I have one. So I do have one. They're really awesome. And it was given to me by Cali Girl Rider, which is a Southern California vlogger. Next? Who's next?
Fine. I have one. It's located like right above it's like right above my wheel and next to my radiator area, if I could explain it. I can't explain it right now, but Mario gave that one to me and gave the story in a nutshell, like you put on the side chat, Goat. And I wanted to buy it myself. I was like, let me go buy it. And he's like, he smacks my hands. He's like, no, you're not supposed to buy it. And I was like, why? He's like, because the person has to give it to you. That's not how it goes. And so I didn't know what he talked about until he actually explained it to me. I was like, okay, you pick the bell. And I was like, can you pick this one? He's like, no, you can't pick it. I'm like, okay, all right, I'll take whatever you give me.
This is
no one has ever told me about this, and yeah, I have never heard. Yeah, this is going to be like an American thing or some south of the border thing.
It actually originates from the, I guess you could say, the cruiser world more so.
I was looking them up, and they're on Amazon, and they looked kind of that style that you
they're more like a cruiser thing. There's a much deeper story to it than what I wrote in the nutshell in the side chat. I just wanted to summarize.
Yeah, for sure.
Ninja basically is saying you can't buy them yourself. So right. Assuming somebody has to buy it for you.
Correct.
Yeah, that's what Battleborn just said that Mario told her as well.
Oh, okay, yeah, this is all new to me. I am just learning about this now. That's crazy.
Yeah, Gremlin bells, that's what I
You can't be safe unless someone else cares enough to spend $9 on a bell for you or whatever.
Well, I don't know. I guess the principle's behind it, like, you know, it's the same idea like those dream catchers.
But I guess what I'm getting at is if you don't have any riding friends or are willing to buy you one, then you'll never be safe from the gremlins, right?
Here we go. I got a picture of one. Hang on. Let me screen share really quick. Oh, what fucking screen is that? Not the midget porn. Not the goat porn. Oh, man. I'm a sick... I am a sick fuck. Hang on. All right. I think this is the right screen. So. Here we go.
Dude.
So the one that I have is, like, right there to the right of my M4 exhaust, like, right on the brake lever. You can see it. And that's where mine's located, and that's kind of what they look like. So
that's cool.
There, I think I'm screen sharing you now.
Yeah, ta-da! All right.
So where is it exactly?
It's like on his foot peg almost there, just to,
or oh, yeah, where the rear brake is.
Yeah, okay, I see it. Yeah, that's pretty cool, and it's literally just a bell.
Yeah, that's all it is.
Mm-hmm. Cool. We all learned something today. Us Canadian folk learned something today.
Maybe I'll get a cowbell on the back of my bike or something now.
Just to mess around. I get a lot. I see a lot of people with like the deer whistles on their belt. So it's like those little, I guess, like little whistles that we can't hear, but they put them on like their cars or bikes.
Yeah, a lot of people up north. I see. That's like a necessity for people up north in their cars if they want to try and keep deer away.
Yeah, exactly.
Hello?
You got any more questions for us, Mr. A Nation?
Yes, sir, I do. I'm just trying to reply to some people that are asking questions just now. Okay, so I have a question for you guys, actually. Screw everybody else. I have a question for you guys. My question to you guys is, how do I word this? How do you guys, if you could rate it from 1 to 10, how do you guys maintain your motorcycles? And be honest. Like, do you actually lube your chain every time you do an oil change or every so often? Like, are you strict on, like, oh, no, I can't go out riding because I have to do this maintenance or I have to check the tightness of my bolts? Like, how diligent are you on your maintenance? Quietness.
Well, Split Eye left, so it's just Battleborn and I.
Oh yeah, he's all.
And I was trying to be polite and let her go first.
Fair enough.
No, I was trying to think because I'm not super strict when it comes to that. Like, if I need an oil change on my bike, I don't go like oh, I cannot ride one more mile over it. I can't just, oh. I don't, I'm not that strict about
well,
it.
Maybe the question's a little too strict, then let me put it in the context. So a few months ago, I took a long trip up north, and I was telling myself, I'm like, oh, I have to make sure I go and I, like, check everything on the bike. But, of course, I procrastinated, and I didn't check everything on it. And, like, you know, I did the oil change, and I got all that ready, but I didn't really give it a good check. Like, I didn't put a lot of effort into it. Halfway up north, like, my whole brake assembly lever, that whole bracket became loose, and I pretty much almost lost my rear brake. So, like, you know what I mean? So the question is like, how diligent are you on keeping up on, like, you know, everyday maintenance on your bike? Not like, oh, it's scheduled for its next oil change. Like,
Before
you actually check your
check. Oh, are you talking about how thorough are we with our pre-checks?
Yeah, exactly. Do you actually check the tire pressures?
I fucking pre-check my bike the day before I ride it and the day I ride it, and then anytime I pull off to get gas or anything, I pre-check it again.
Nice.
I'm very, very thorough about pre-checks because all it takes is one nail, one mistake, one loose bolt to end your life.
Yep, it's absolutely right. Absolutely, it doesn't matter what you're riding too. Could be a 50cc, could be a 1000cc.
I'll even walk up to people's bikes, like if people are riding with me at gas stations, and I'll fuck with their levers and shit, and people just look at me like, "What the fuck, goat?" And I won't tell them, but it's just, you know, it's just a safety thing, dude. You never know.
He's concerned. He wants to make sure you're safe.
I've been falling into that habit where I don't pre-check. And because of that ride up north where I almost lost my rear brake assembly, right? Like, literally, I caught it when the bolt had, like, two threads left. And I'm like, damn, like, I could have avoided that if I had just, like, if I had looked at it, I would have been like, okay, that's loose, right? So, now I, you know, I make sure there's air in my tires, there's fucking oil in it, there's whatever. You never know, right? So.
Well, that's what each ride that we go to, I check the brakes and, you know, the clutch and everything else looks ready to go. The lights, make sure all the lights are working. Make sure the tires have no nails or anything bulging out of it. Just everything looks good. And just make sure it's nothing's, like, stiff about it, like the brake-wise or something, or too loose. I mean, every, like, before, like, pre-check it each time. But I thought your original question was, like, if you, it was, like, really strict. I was like, well, I'm going to still ride my bike if it's, like, due for an oil change. I'm not going to go crazy over it.
Yeah, same here.
I was like, I'm still going to ride it. If I go ride to the store to get this stuff myself, you know?
I've been riding around on fucking bald tires in the center for, like, a month now. I've got a little bit of tread on the sides. That's all I need.
You can just lean to the side a little bit.
But it's honestly, like, to bring that point up, it's a pretty important thing. Like, not saying like you have to know how to maintain your bike, because there's always gonna be people riding that don't know how to work or maintain on their own bike, and that's fine. That's okay. Like, as long as you know the basic fundamentals of riding a motorcycle and riding it safe, that's fine.
Well, I think it's like the same thing that plays into owning a car, because owning a car, you're supposed to do pre-checks on your vehicle before you drive it and all that stuff. You're supposed to check the tire pressure and all that stuff. It's no different than a motorcycle, but people just become complacent.
Yeah, you know? the people that like pump gas and go kind of people. Like, all they know how to do is operate the vehicle and put gas in it. So, like, it's, you know, if they got a flat tire, they'd have no idea what to do. Like, I don't know about you guys, but do you know what to do if you have a flat tire on a bike?
I ride off a mountain.
There's a lot of things that a lot of riders don't understand, and a basic pre-check on the bike, which literally a basic pre-check could take no longer than 30 seconds, right? So just getting on your bike and doing that first could save your life, yeah. Absolutely.
If you have a nail in your tire on your bike, it's going to be completely different than a car, because a car has three other tires to hold you up. I mean, it's going to be a rough ride versus a bike. Chances are not looking good.
Yeah, the only thing that's keeping you alive on a motorcycle is your tires. That's it. I mean, the tires are the most important part of your motorcycle. Your bike can ride itself without you on it, thanks to the fucking tires and the phenomena of the motorcycle. One of those tires goes out, it's game over for the bike. So, I mean, if you're on the bike, it's that much worse.
No, absolutely. And again, that goes to owning, you know, like a $300 motorcycle to a, you know, a $30,000 motorcycle. Like, your tires, if your tires are shit, you're going down. Absolutely. All right, we'll move on from that one, because that one's kind of, there's so much to get onto that one. But, I had it listed up here. We're just going to skip all the questions that say, what should your first bike be? Because getting a little tired of that one. Okay, here's one. Did you take your, in America, what's it called? The MFS? MSF? What's it called?
MSF.
The NSA.
No, MSF, Motorcycle Safety
Foundation. MSF, yeah. I don't know if it splits in the conversation. What's it called for us?
I'm here.
Hey, he's got a puppy. Who's your puppy? It's like just a motorcycle safety course. So MSC, I guess. But did you get your motorcycle license first, or did you take the course first?
I took the course first.
Yeah?
I learned how to ride the bike the first time during the course. I've never ridden a bike before.
Does your course offer you the test as well to get your license?
Yeah.
Yeah. Same idea then, yeah. Goat?
I've taken an MSF, yeah.
But what did you do first? Did you get your motorcycle license first, or the motorcycle course first?
No, I started riding back in 2008, off and on. And then the only reason why I really went and took an MSF is because my buddy Phoenix got into riding. So he's like, I'm going to go take the MSF. And I was like, fuck it, I'll go take an MSF then.
Yeah. Split. It's gone. This guy just keeps popping in and out. For me, I actually got my license first. I got my license when I was young. And then, I don't know, 6 years later, I took the course, and I learned so many new things that I had no idea about.
That's one thing I want to do is go take, like, a intermediate course and whatnot and learn more from there.
Next year, girlfriend. Next year.
Yeah, how does your licensing system work? So for us, we get a beginner's license, I guess. So it's like a restricted license.
America doesn't work like that. America, okay, you get license, you're done.
Explain how ours works, and then I guess you could explain how it works in Reno. So we get like a beginner's license, and then you're on probation where you have to drive with somebody for a year. Like, you always have to have somebody in your vehicle with you. And then once you pass that, you take a road test, and then you get an intermediate license, which is good for up to, I think, 5 years. And that's so you can gain experience. And then once 5 years hits, you have to go get your graduated license, which is your full. So there's like three phases.
Hmm. Well, with us, if you want to start with the basics, we do have a permit where you have to like contribute a few hours in the daylight and nighttime, then take a written test, and driver's test. And then once you pass that, you get your license, and that's it. There's no steps beyond that.
Really?
You just renew it every so often.
Like for a motorcycle license, you get what's called your M1, your motorcycle license 1, I guess. I don't even know what the 1 stands for. I guess it's just 1. Anyway, and with that is you're not allowed to have a passenger. You can't ride on a highway. So anything over 80 kilometers an hour, which I, whatever, 60, 45, I think. Anything, like, you can't go freeway speeds, and you're not allowed to ride at night. That you have to do that for a minimum of, I can't remember now, I think a year. And then you have 2 more steps to go after that.
Yeah, we don't have that.
That's crazy. So you just do your written test, you go through your probation period, and then get your full license?
Oh, that's how I got when I got my driver's license. It's just I had my permit and then took... You know, like I said, the driver's test, and once I passed that, I got my license. And then for my bike, I just took the course, passed it, and then got the endorsement, and I have it on my license. I don't have to follow any kind of restrictions or anything. I can just ride whenever I want. I can carry a passenger if I want to, too.
Once you have a driver's license, any other license that you get is a endorsement. It's not restricted.
Yeah.
But if you're asking if we were to start out fresh with no license, then yeah, we'd have a permit just like if we had a driver's license permit. So
yeah.
So if we were starting out, no driver's license, no motorcycle license, then yes, we'd have a permit. But if we already have a driver's license, we can go and take the test and end up with the endorsement, no restrictions.
Oh yeah. That's pretty crazy. Got another question here. This one's coming from somebody. It's coming from Instagram. He's watching on his phone. I'm assuming he's watching it on his phone. I don't know if you guys have the same issue or not. When I watch live Hangouts on my phone, I can't chat.
You have to load it from the actual YouTube website, not from the YouTube app.
So I have an iPhone. It won't let me do that. It's so weird. And I've been able to force load it from like the website, but then I can't get the live chat to even show. So I have no idea. If anybody has an iPhone and they can live chat on an iPhone, please DM me and let me know how to do it. It's pissing me off. Anyways, we'll get to the question though. So the question is, how did we all come up with our names? That came from Hot Rodder 19. How did you come up with your name? Battleborn.
Okay, fine. Mario picked it up for me.
Mario?
Yeah. I couldn't think of a name to save me because I'm terrible with nicknames. I have no idea. Just give me like any nickname and it looks good to me, I'll take it. I'm not that creative. And yeah. So I was struggling with it, and then he picked it out for me. So I was like, oh, okay, I'll take it. I liked it. So I was like, oh, okay, that's good enough for me.
It's actually a pretty cool name. And when you explained it to me, because like where you're from is called Battleborn, right?
Yeah, it's the Battleborn State.
Yeah, so that actually makes sense. Like, it makes a lot of sense.
So if you come to Nevada, then you'll see, like, sometimes you see banners, or sometimes you go to places, they'll say Vataborn on her, because that's the nickname for the state of Nevada, or the Silver State, but you mostly see Vataborn everywhere. So I pretty much, if you put Battleborn Rider, I'm like a Nevada rider. So, in other words.
Nice. Mm-hmm. How about you, Goat?
I'm the greatest of all time.
Greatest of all time.
Yeah, just, father.
Greatest of all time, father.
I had to spell that out. Is that actually how you came up with it?
No. So, I just
look
at it.
Why couldn't you just say yes? Because that would have been epic.
Yeah, I'm a dad who has kids, so I look at my kids as goats, because they fucking eat everything. They eat my wallet, as in money. So I was like, goat father, done. And I've had this name for, like, over a decade, so, yep. The end. Nothing exciting.
So it just kind of, well, it kind of is. Like, it stuck with you for so long, right?
Yeah.
I didn't hear you.
That's pretty cool. For me, I've always, my tag, and like, I guess like my whole online history, my tag has always been nation. So like, you know, when I was in like car forums, it's something related, car related nation, you know, other forums, whatever related nation. So I was literally gonna go Moto Nation. Like, that was gonna be my name for the longest time. And I'm like, that's such a cool name. I wanna do that, like Moto Nation, it's so awesome. I don't know, and then I don't hide it. Like, my name is Aaron, right? Spelled with two A's. And for the last 10 years of my life, everybody's been calling me Aaron. And if you know where that joke is from, props on you. So it just kind of stuck, like the A dash A, and so that's what I went with.
Prezant.
And Mario's in the house.
Yes, yes.
What's up?
So yeah, if you know where Aaron, that funny skit is from, props on you. And if you don't, I will put it in the side chat. So Ghost probably like, what the fuck are you talking about?
No, I know what you're talking about, because you told us about this like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, I probably did, yeah. Yeah, I talk about a lot of things all the time.
I have a very good memory.
Absolutely. I do not. I have a horrible memory. Oh man. So I think we lost Split Eye. I don't know where he went.
I'm still here. I've just been doing things. Sorry.
Oh, that's okay. That's okay. You know, do what you gotta do, sir. No pressure.
So when is the other live stream with Goat happening, where they're interviewing him?
What?
There's a live stream, I think Tattoo.
Hey, Mario, I'm sorry you're breaking up. Why don't you, all right, there we go. So, yeah, A Nation, why don't you go ahead and ask us, like, another question, because I got to actually bounce out of here in a minute. I don't have a lot of time tonight. I just wanted to come in and be supportive and hang out for a bit.
Yeah, not a problem. So, we're going to get another question.
One that Mario doesn't ask, preferably.
One that Mario doesn't ask. I feel like there's some tension brewing there. Like, there shouldn't be something.
There's a lot of sexual tension between us. I taught him how to use a fucking torque wrench.
True story, bro.
Oh, that's too funny. All right, I'm gonna find a good one for you here. I gotta find a good. Well, that one. See, some of these don't really apply to all of us, so can't really use that. That's too common. Why does everybody ask the same question over and over again?
Honestly, it's not the people per se. It's that we get so used to answering the same questions over and over that we don't realize that there's a lot of new people who never hear us answer the questions, you know?
Yeah, it's just the volume of people that ask, I guess.
Right. So you could answer, what type of motorcycle is the best motor to start with 1 million fucking times, and then you got to realize that there's still 6.9 billion people on the planet, so they're all going to ask you that same fucking question again, you know what I mean? That's just how it goes. I hear you, though, man. I've been doing hangouts for... I think we just hit 9 months. So oh, yeah. I have heard some questions get asked like on a daily fucking basis, dude, to where I'm just like, oh my god.
Yeah, but you make a good point though. There's a lot of people that haven't, like, you know, they'll jump in the chat one time and ask a question, not realizing it's been asked 1,000 times already.
Right. So. I think like 2 weeks ago, there were like 6 hangouts in a row and I was on every one of them, and the same set of questions got asked on every one of those shows. So about the third day, I was ready to just say, fuck this, stop doing hangouts. But then I had to tell myself that there's people out there that don't know the answers, and I'm doing them a disservice if I don't answer. So
yeah.
But what's the perfect starter bike, Goat?
Say that again?
What's the perfect starter bike, Goat?
One that where the next time you need my help, I'm going to fucking poison your bike.
Yeah, the perfect starter bike is the one that has 2 wheels.
Yeah. All right, I'll I got
a question that kind of intrigues me a little bit. It's a bit of an editing question. So there's 2 parts to this question. One part, what software do you use while you're editing? And number 2, where do you keep all your spare footage? Like, I guess I can break that into 2A and 2B. So like, do you keep every piece of footage that you own, or after you edit, you get rid of the footage?
I still keep mine.
Every single piece of footage you've collected?
Oh, so far, you know, space is limited. I mean, we have the Mac can hold 1 terabyte. I think I bought a backup hard drive of 3 terabytes, and that's filling up pretty quick. So unless she wants to get another one, she's gonna have to make a decision pretty soon here.
Oh yeah. Goat.
I use Adobe Premiere, and I keep, I would say, like a 50-50 split of my footage. I usually go through a lot of my footage and say, oh, well, this is the same fucking road that I've rode 40 fucking times. There's nothing interesting on it, so I'll delete that. But I'm a really strong advocate to encourage people to keep a lot of their old footage, especially because if you rewatch a lot of your old footage, you might find little diamonds in that footage that you didn't even realize were there, so.
Yeah. Yep.
And I keep it all on external hard drives.
Yeah, I have to agree with you there. I keep everything I own, I keep on external hard drives. And the reason I do that is because eventually one day in my life, I'm going to go back on all my old footage and try and make some kind of montage or some kind of, I don't know, old video, or find something that I haven't seen before. But it's filling up pretty quick. I mean, I think I have, like, I don't know. I just started doing this in the summer, middle of the summer, and I think I already have, like, almost 1 terabyte full of footage already. So, like, it doesn't take long. When you're filming in 60 frames, 1080p, it doesn't take long to fill it up.
Yeah, I hear that. Well, I hate to be a fucking... whatever word you would use for me dropping out, but I got to take off, guys. A-Nation, it was awesome to see you, man. Definitely, definitely like doing hangouts with you. I'm sorry to bounce on you like this, man.
Yeah, no worries, man. Thanks for coming in, and sorry I haven't been around the last couple of weeks. I feel like I'm letting everybody down.
Oh, no, man, you're fine. We all have lives, dude. You got to do you. And Kara, Mario, hopefully I will see both of you on Sunday so we can get some footage of you guys. But that's for another hangout to talk about. So bye, everybody, and make sure to check out my new website. It's called goatporn.com. It's going to have Kara and Mario on there. And y'all have a wonderful weekend. I'll see you next time.
That's too funny.
See ya.
I got a little thing. I think it's funny.
So then it was down to just 2.
Technically 3. I got Mario here.
No. That's true. Technically 3. Yeah. I don't get anybody that wants to come hang out with me anymore.
Well, Ninja Bakes just came in.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I just sent him the invite. Actually, I sent him the invite a while ago, but I never actually hit send on the message box. So. My bad, sir. Oh. Mr. Ninja Basics, how are you?
I can't do it.
No. Excellent, excellent news. He's probably over there trying to figure out his mic situation, too.
Apparently, I have a really bad issue with people and their microphones.
Mm.
Oh, Mario, put my shirt on.
See?
I can't believe you got my shirt before I did.
America! Fuck yeah!
That's so awesome. Guys, anybody who's listening, Mario has a limited edition 3K Club shirt that I'm actually... my last campaign just ended, so I got to put that back on Teespring. But I'm only offering these shirts while I'm at 3K, so... Time's running out because I'm gaining subs by the hour. Hashtag not. I wish.
He's like, there he is wearing it.
Yeah, exactly. I wish. Maybe I need to get into a motorcycle crash and then everybody will sub to me. So there's a question for you guys, actually, that some people has asked me before. Do you care about subscribers or do you care more about your content?
I care about more content.
Yeah. Absolutely, I'm with you on that. I don't want to say I care more about, obviously I care about my content. I care more about my views, I guess, if that makes any sense. Because I every time I get a view, I'm like, hey, that's awesome. Like, somebody watched my stuff. Like, that's what makes me feel good, right? Like, I put something out there, and somebody watched it.
Well, they can technically watch, 5 seconds and say they watched your video.
I guess, yeah, but you have to put yourself in somebody else's shoes too. Like, do you watch every minute of every video on YouTube?
You may never know. I'm just saying.
The people coming back later and watching this chat right now, they're gonna be like skimming through this shit. they're gonna be like, oh, what? This chat was 2 hours long. Fuck that. I'm gonna skim through it. So, but at least somebody wanted to watch my content. That means something to me.
Well, I'm just saying for the subs, I do care about anyone that's subbed to my channel will actually watch my stuff. I mean, yeah. I really thank them for, dedicating their time to watch my stuff and actually enjoy it if they do. And I really do appreciate them devoting their time and effort to even give me the comments or like or what say you. But when it comes to actually my channel, I just like it for the content of it because I like to go back and watch my shit. I was like, that's cool. I'm impressed with myself to do it. Yeah. I'm like, oh, that was a pretty cool trip, I was like, yeah, and then, oh, I remember that day, it was warm. God damn it, why isn't it like that right now?
Yeah, I hear that. I it's so funny, I'll go back and I'll watch, footage, and I'll remember that day exactly.
Yeah, yeah. No, my most recent one, I was like, oh, that was a nice day. I was like, oh, that was a quite nice ride, the weather was perfect. Yeah.
Had a fucking chili dog that day, it was so good.
Right? It was like, I had pizza this day. That's a good restaurant. I should go there next time.
I want that chili dog so bad. How are we maintaining viewers with only two people in this chat? It's all you. It's definitely not me. It's definitely got to be you.
You got to show your boobies.
I got to show my boobies. Hey, everybody. Come watch the chat. Battleborn showing her boobies. Dude, do it. Do it. We'll get all the subs now.
Yeah,
help.
Oh, yeah, you
get
when you said that.
Oh, exactly, yeah. We just gained, four watchers. Ninja Basics, are you up in this chat?
Is it?
yeah, that's exactly. Well, we got Ninja Basics here. I think he's an up-and-coming motovlogger. I don't know him personally, but I have been he's been recommended by me by a few different people. Clearly, these people don't know anything about microphones.
Actually, I do. It's just that the microphone on my laptop is broken.
Hallelujah. There you go. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good. I had some difficulties going from the YouTube message to the window for this because of the fact that I have a Mac from, 2006, so it's kind of old and craptastic.
Nice. Well, I'm surprised you got it working.
Yeah, well, I had the same problem whenever I hopped in with Will last time he hosted.
Yeah, it seems, I think K-Dub's having that same issue, too.
Well, I think is what it is the stuff, for the settings, for the sound settings, it doesn't automatically switch over to the speaker in the Bluetooth, and then when it does, it cuts off the audio, so I have to go back in and turn the audio on.
Dude, if you're subscribed to me and you've watched a few of my hangouts, you'll know that I'm not really internet savvy. So those are just a bunch of big words for me.
I mean, I'm not really tech savvy myself, so, like, honestly, until Will added me that time that he did the substitute teacher thing, I had no idea how Hangouts worked when, it, like, when you're doing it with the conjunction with YouTube. So I had fun trying to figure that out on the fly.
Yeah, let me tell you. Hey, I see you, Will. I see you. Okay, you can't say that. Will in the office. I think people are more excited for Will than they are for me. I don't know if we should be happy about that or not. But I'm glad we got Will. We got Will. Will Moto up in the chat. What's going on, Will?
I'm trying to find a quiet place to hide and see if I can participate for a little bit.
I don't know. It looked like you were trying to prank somebody real quick.
Yeah.
No, I was just trying to sneak up on somebody. No, I'm at work. Hopefully nobody that knows me in real life is watching.
In real life? Like, your boss?
No.
I felt bad because you only had two people in here.
I know, everybody's sort of dropping out like flies, but that's okay. We're just here to chat.
You can get a chat.
That's my fault.
I
didn't really promote this chat whatsoever. It was literally like last minute. I'm like, oh yeah, it's Thursday. I should probably do one of these. I don't normally have
my webcam on because I'm on the cell phone. You get to see
everybody else is showing their face, so I figured why not.
Yep. Oh, for A Nation, he's too shy to show his face now.
I was showing my face, but my internet started lagging, so I shut it off. But I can hop back on the cam here. But don't blame me if I'm fucking.
He's trying to hide how many beers he's drinking.
Yeah, there's a lot of them. I got some beers in here. I may have a problem, and I have my gold stereo. Wait, it's on that side. There we go.
It's like, yeah, your big ass hands in the way.
Yeah, exactly. I figured that one out. Yep. So this is just gonna be I think it's just gonna be a fucking random ass fucking chat. Fuck, I can't remember your name now. Hold on, I gotta go over your thing. Ninja Basics, there we go. Where are you from?
Yep. I'm down here in Georgia.
In Georgia? In Georgia? Yep. I feel like I have an accent.
You know, it's actually really funny, because growing up, a lot of people that I met, like, going through grade school, they all talk like this, and whenever I didn't sound that way, they all thought that I was from, like, up north or something. And even when I lived in Oregon for 2 years, everybody was like, there's no way you're from the south. And I was like, yeah, kind of.
Yeah, you don't sound like you're from the south.
No, you don't. You really don't. You mean, you got a hint of it, but you're not, like, that whole really thick accent of it, a dialect.
Well, I mean, if it'll make you guys feel better, I can participate in that way. I mean, shoot.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, you got to start talking like that. I can participate that way.
Oh, my.
I don't know. I do the worst accents ever. Don't look at me. Every accent I try and come out with sounds like Jamaican. Yeah, man. Everything I read. Yeah, everything I read. That's my accents.
Yeah. Well, one of the other funny things. I used to do a lot of theater stuff in high school and like right after high school, and so I've always thought the British accent's really cool, and so I got pretty good at doing one of those. But after having one of the substitute teachers who was actually from England like walk up to me in the lunch line and kind of call me out, and like he was like, oh, what part of, you know, where are you from? And I was like, oh shit. So you know, he obviously thought it was a good enough accent that he thought I was actually from Europe. So I was like, well, whatever.
Nice. Yeah, I don't have
an accent.
Like, on my job, I work with a bunch of Irish guys, and they're so fucking funny. Like, it's like they're obviously Irish. You can get that, but it's not the way they speak. It's the fucking context that they speak in. It's ridiculous.
Right, like the words that they put into sentences and like what they use to describe.
It's everything. Yeah. Actually, I gotta pull this up. I'm gonna pull this up right now. Irish. Irish slang. Yeah. So, we're gonna play a little game, alright? German-Irish slang, no, that's like German-Irish midget porn.
Whoa.
I don't want to participate in this anymore.
hold on, wait.
Will's like, please do not participate.
I'm out.
No, hold on. We got Irish slang. Okay, here's going to be the game. I'm going to say a phrase from, I don't know what the, like, somebody once told me where, like, okay, we'll get this. Maybe you guys from the States will get this. So, like, when we make fun of somebody in Canada, we kind of call them, like, a newfie. Like, it's, like, our worst part of Canada. So what would be, like, your worst part of, like, the States?
Like,
if you were to make fun of one state, what would it be?
Oh, Alabama, for sure, which is actually kind of sad because I'm right next door to that.
Battle?
Wait, which state's the worst?
Like, what state would you make fun of? Like, has the worst accent or the stupidest people, I guess.
Any state in the South.
Ouch.
Any southern state.
Well, see, she's talking about the people that talk like this.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, but...
Talking about the people that talk like this, you see? I feel like those people still believe in slavery. Like, when you talk like that, I feel like you're back in, like, the fucking 40s.
Well, I do declare that upon that time of conception of the idea of slavery, that they
well, the
might...
Confederacy! Yeah, exactly. It was good. I give this speech in honor of the Confederacy. Oh, man.
I declare that the South is the loser of the Civil War.
That's like the Great Wild West, man.
Dude, you should just do more of this. This should just be your thing. You should start a YouTube channel where you just start saying random shit that is, like, now in news today, but you should, like, redo the news as if you were, like, a Confederate general from the South.
Okay, well, give me something that you've seen in the news in the past couple of days besides the San Bernardino shooting, and I'll try it.
I don't know. The only interesting thing in the news I have is right now in Toronto, we're having a big taxi and Uber war. So Uber for us is, I think, what Lyft is for you guys.
I've been following that, A-Nation, and those taxi drivers are being stupid. Absolutely stupid. Just, you don't cause this kind of bullshit and then expect everyone else to get on your side. That's not how it works.
We just had a taxi protest because we have this new system that's like app related where you can get like it's like ride sharing online, right? And it's like putting all the cabbies out of business because it's so inexpensive. So the cabbies have been protesting, and then yesterday like a cabbie like attacked a fucking Uber driver and like hung on to his mirror while being dragged down the road. It was fucking ridiculous.
He was, like, hitting his car and everything. And I think the biggest problem was they were driving down the 401 at, like, 40 kilometers an hour, which is, like, a crawling pace on a major highway, and holding up traffic during rush hour in the middle of the city. You don't do that shit. Yeah, you don't do that shit if you want the people to be on your side, because now you're affecting everyone else's day. They're not going to be on your side anymore. Goodbye, cabbies. In Toronto, that's what's going to happen.
All right, we'll get to the news thing really quick. I just got this up here. We're going to play a little game. It's going to be called "What the fuck does this mean?" So I'm going to find Irish slang and Irish phrases, and you guys have to tell me what it means. Alrighty?
I actually might be kind of good at that.
All right, here you go. Irish slang number one. Sticking thorns up your arse.
Sticking thorns up your arse?
Sticking thorns up your arse. Ah, you're sticking thorns up your ass.
Oh, that's probably referring to the fact of like we have a phrase down here called blowing smoke up your ass, which is basically when somebody's bullshitting you.
Yeah.
Nope.
You never heard that? Oh.
Well, I was going to say, aside from a pain in the ass, that's all I could think of it meaning.
Wait, maybe it is. Doing something that only succeeds in irritating yourself.
Well, I mean... Yeah,
why would you do it, then?
I have no idea, man. I'm not Irish, bro. Oh, man.
So, yay, I got chat up. We're good.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not Irish, man. There's too many bad ones here. Here, what's this one? My back teeth are swimming.
What the fuck?
Yeah, my back teeth are swimming.
You're gargling?
Nope.
you're drinking too much.
Nope. That would be a good one, though. I would think that. Paddle, I mean, you got an answer for this one?
Back teeth are swimming. That's something in your mouth. I don't know. I'm guessing.
No, it means you gotta take a piss.
What?
It means you gotta take a piss.
Oh, well, down here in the South, we usually say our eyeballs are floating.
Eyeballs are floating.
Oh, I get it now.
Yeah. For me, it would just be like, I gotta take a leak.
Yeah. Well, there's other terms.
Like, if you're ever in the South and, like, somebody happens to be around you and be like, damn, dude, my eyeballs are floating, that means that they're about 2 minutes away from doing the pee-pee dance.
how about this one? You wouldn't swing a cat in it.
You wouldn't swing a cat in it.
You wouldn't swing a cat in it.
I wouldn't have sex with her.
No, no. But I see where you're coming from. And no, yeah. I wouldn't have sex with her either. Anybody else want to take a stag at that one? You wouldn't swing a cat in it.
It looks like Will's trying to draw a penis.
Will's trying to draw a diagram.
What is the term then?
Okay, so you wouldn't swing a cat in it. It's actually meant to describe a small space or a small room.
Odd.
Yeah, I know, right? They're fucked.
Yeah.
The fuck shit is this?
Well, it's okay. After you get done doing the Irish ones, I'll look up Southern words and see if y'all can guess what Southern words mean.
Oh, you should do it for us.
Yeah, that's okay. Well, here, hold on. I'll do it. Oh, well, I have to find the words first.
You should just know it.
Well, I do know some of them.
All right, while he's doing that, I'm going to take off, get back to work.
Yes. Oh, Will, you actually have to work?
Sorry. Yeah, no, there's a lot going on tonight. I try my best, man. I try my best. Plus, I've been in the side chat, so I don't know how to get the side chat with this Hangout app, but I will go back to the side chat. Peace out, everybody. Buddy.
Thanks. Take care. And then there were two. Actually, MintR6 just came up in the chat. I think I sent her an invite. I did. Get your ass in here. We're hurting. We lost all our viewers because Goat left.
Right. They all came for the goat.
Yeah, they don't like you.
Everybody wants the goat.
Goat's a cool dude. Actually, I had a real funny small world moment because I was scrolling through some of his older videos. And there's a place in Canby, Oregon called Park. It's PARC. And it's basically a go-kart track that, like, every month they do, like, a small drift event where you can pay, like, $150 and you can come out there and drift for the weekend. And I went to their 2014 park, which is, like, their big thing that they do. And turns out he actually is one of the people who helped start that whole park thing.
Yeah.
So, like, it was kind of cool that somebody that I bumped into online turns out to be somebody that started one of the drift events that I went to.
That's pretty crazy. Here, I got another one.
Okay.
if I were to, hey, let's go out and get some tins.
Come out and get some what?
Some tins.
Some tins? You're right.
I want to grab some tins. What did you say it was?
Like, I'm going to say, like, I don't know, I'm going to say beer or, like, chewing tobacco for some reason.
Yeah, you got it.
It was going out for beers.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I want to do some of these Georgia ones.
All right, here you go.
Okay, but before we do that, I just have to finish on this last one.
All right, go ahead.
What the fuck is a carpet cleaner? Come on.
Okay, I know, you really... Yeah.
Come on, Kara, say it.
Is that really what I think it is?
It really is.
Then you can just say it, because you already know what I mean.
You can say it. It's got to come from you.
No.
Come on now.
You know what I'm thinking, so yeah, we already know what the answer is. So
Kara, what is a carpet cleaner?
Just say it.
She's blushing. Actually, I'm probably I'm going to go off cam now, because I'm blushing more than she is.
Dude, you know exactly.
I'm also a little fucking drunk, so. All right, we'll stop on that one. If you don't know what a carpet cleaner is, Google it.
Right.
Or blue waffles, right?
Do not Google blue waffles. Don't.
Or you, while you're at it, I'm saying. So. Carry on.
Okay. So, I actually have some of them, but because my sound keeps cutting out, I'm going to have to turn off the cam because my computer can't keep up with side chat and audio. So.
Too much internet for you.
Well, I mean, like I said, this thing is from 06. Actually, you know, it might help if I turn on my fan, my fan speed up a little bit here.
You can designate fan speed?
Well, my sister's a big computer nerd, and she's all about Apple products, and so last time she had this, she took and upgraded the RAM in it to, the max that it can hold, and then she put a fan speed controller on it because it was overheating.
I'm dying. I'm literally dying on this end.
Right now, my, the temperature gauge that it has for the internals of my computer, it's, right now streaming all of this, it's, 196 degrees.
Wow.
But I bumped the fan up, so it's a drop-in, and it might actually work better now. Anyway, back to the southern words y'all wanted to hear.
Y'all, I want to hear it.
Y'all. Do you want me to do it with the southern accent?
Buddy, I wouldn't have invited you in the chat if I otherwise. Come on now. I need to hear the southern accent.
Okay. Clodhopper.
Wow.
A clodhopper?
Clod, D as in dog. Clodhopper.
The fuck? Mm. like fucking. A clodhopper. You know what comes to my mind is somebody who fucking has sex with a lot of people, a slut.
No, not even close.
God, this is horrible.
Clodhopper. Oh, I have no idea. The fuck is that?
It's the southern term used for talking about if you have big bulky shoes or boots on.
Stupidest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Right. Well, over on Battleborn's side of the country, they probably, if she deals with a lot of people from Texas or that are, of the Western style, they probably call them shit kickers.
Yeah, I've heard that term before, yeah.
Yeah, clodhoppers is basically the southern version of shit kicker.
Oh, okay.
All right. Let's see. Well, shit, these are actually all expressions. Hang on. fuck.
Ragamuffin.
Ragamuffin?
Hey, what's a... Yeah, ragamuffin.
Damn it, man.
That came from 3-star recruits. What's a ragamuffin?
Ragamuffin?
Yeah. is that like a carpet cleaner?
No.
Dude, wait. Do you need a ragamuffin after the carpet cleaner? Or is that pre-carpet cleaner where you grab a ragamuffin?
No, ragamuffin is what you use before the carpet cleaner.
I don't know what it is, but it sounds funny.
Right, no. Ragamuffin is usually what, at least where when I was littler, anytime somebody said ragamuffin, they were usually referring to, somebody or something being, small and cutesy.
Okay, that reminds me of, you know what that reminds me of? Have anybody ever watched the movie Clerks? Or Clerks 2, regardless? Where he's like, oh, I'm just a little porch monkey. you can't say that. That's a racial slur against black people. And it's like, no, it's not.
That's just something
my grandmother used to call me for being a lazy kid on a porch. It doesn't mean I was a lazy black kid. And then it's like, wait a second. My grandmother did refer to a broken beer bottle as a. I don't want to say it, but.
Yeah. And oh, so, man. He's like, come to think of it, my grandmother was a little.
Yeah,
racist.
It was a little racist. And then what else did he say? He was like, well, you can't say porch monkey because not black. And he's like, look at you telling me what I can and cannot say because of the color of my skin. You fucking racist.
And then, how you said that, but then he started citing all other slurs.
Yeah, it is so fucking good. If you haven't seen Clerks 2, or Clerks for that matter at all, go fucking see it.
Yeah, I watch all the time.
It's too fucking funny. So, actually, fun fact about Clerks, since you watch it.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
You got to meet him in person. So.
Yeah.
Oh, fuckers.
Yeah, we did. They were pretty cool people. So if you ever get to do like a photo op with them, do it. They were very personable.
So did you know that what's-his-face dropped out of college to film Clerks 1?
You were talking about Kevin Smith?
Yeah, so he dropped out of college, film college, took his tuition and filmed like the original Clerks in black and white to like save money or some shit. I don't know, something like that.
I just know that I used to watch that. I still constantly watch it. I almost know like almost every word to that movie. I watched it so many times. It's a fucking hilarious movie.
Which movie is that?
Clerks. And Clerks 2, for that matter.
Yeah, but you know what? Like, all their movies are funny. There's a few that aren't, but like Dogma, like Jane, Silent Bob, all that shit is fucking hilarious.
It is.
Yeah.
It's really cool. They're really cool people to meet. If you haven't seen his newest movie, Kevin Smith's movie, Mr. Tusk, I highly recommend it.
All right.
Watch it. Definitely.
Just throw that up in the chat for everybody.
Yeah, watch it. You're not, you know,
now,
yeah.
back to the Confederacy, Genera.
Now,
I don't know if he's listening. No, you're good.
I mean, like I said, most of the stuff that I'm finding is actually all, like, multi-word expressions, and they're pretty self-explanatory. So,
okay, so how about we just have entries from the side chat, and they just say phrases that they'd like you to say in your Southern General Confederacy voice?
I'm down with that.
So, yeah, the sponsor is now... I wish it was sponsored by Kevin Smith. We'd have more than... I think at one point we had 22 people watching, now we have 8.
Yeah, oh, and to answer Three-Star Recruit's question, is Lot Lizard just a Southern thing? It's definitely a Southern term, and is what it refers to are the nasty trampy ladies that run around all the truck stops trying to get rides from place to place by asking sex or by providing sexual favors for truck drivers.
So they're prostitutes?
More or less, but...
I don't think there is any more or less. I think they're just prostitutes.
Well, no, but see, but they don't get money. They just get a list to wherever one of the places. Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much like hookers and whatnot. Yeah.
Oh wait, Will, are you asking me to say your username in the Southern accent?
Do it.
Oh, Sweetheart's in here.
Hey.
Hi, hi, hi.
How are you guys?
Hi, hi, hi. Oh shit, Miss Ehart in the house. Are you a Confederate general?
I don't know what that means.
They're giving me shit because of the fact that I'm in Georgia and I can actually do like a really thick Southern accent, so now we're all trying to think of stupid shit for me to say.
Say yellow.
Yeah.
Oh. Are you talking about saying yeller?
Yeah, that's how my grandma says it, yeller.
But you gotta involve like the Confederacy flag in that, you know, you gotta fucking really get into it.
Get into character.
Now, I do say that there patch of flowers happens to be mighty yeller.
Now, please execute these scum. Wait, who did the Confederacy fight again? I don't even know.
The Union?
Was it the Union? I don't know. I'm from Canada, man. You know who we fought? Nobody. We fought fucking nobody.
Let me get Will's screen name or username in here. That way he'll spazzing because he's using caps.
Oh, that's too funny. Miss Ehart, how are you?
Out to Will Moto.
Oh, I've been better.
What happened?
Well, I don't know. Sunday night, I was sitting on the floor and my back started hurting a little bit, and then I woke up Sunday night in extreme pain to the point where I couldn't even walk Monday or Tuesday.
Oh.
So, yeah, I ended up in the ER. They said they couldn't do shit because they think it's a muscle thing. And they gave me some muscle relaxers and told me to go take it easy for a while.
Did that work?
Kind of ish. I mean, I'm now hobbling around, so that's an improvement. But I'm getting real tired of sitting around doing a whole lot of nothing.
Especially if you want to ride. Weather been good?
The weather has improved to riding status, and I get to sit here and listen to all the bikes drive by.
I hear that. I'm like, you guys are killing me.
Yeah, that sucks.
Probably not the best, but at least even you're not in pain anymore, no?
Yeah, no, that is a plus. That's definitely a plus, dude. It was so horrifically bad. I mean, they were starting to think that maybe I, like, fell and broke my hip, and I'm like, I didn't fall, and they insisted on x-raying my hip, and they're like, we have no idea why you're in that much pain.
I can assure you I didn't fall. I can just tell you that now.
Oh, right, that's what I was telling them. I'm like, I didn't fall. They're like, well, were you in an accident? I'm like, no. They're like, are you sure? I'm like, yeah, I'm pretty positive.
I'm pretty positive I didn't fall. There's something else.
And then they started asking lots more questions, like something had to have happened. And I'm like, no, when it started, I was literally sitting in my floor because I have some issues with some nerves in my upper back. So sitting in the floor actually helps those nerves. And I was shopping online when this started.
Maybe sitting in the floor made you pinch your sciatic or something.
Well, that's what they were saying. They were like, were you sitting Indian style? And I was like, actually, yeah. And they're like, well, that's the only thing we can think.
What is Indian style? And please don't tell me that's like some kind of porn sexual thing.
Well, you had to put the Indians in the temple, and they couldn't all, or not the teepee, sorry. They couldn't all put their legs out.
That's fucking racist. What is Indian style?
It's where when you sit with your legs crossed, yeah? Like when you sit flat on the floor and cross them towards you?
Yeah. Oh, what can make you do in gym class?
Your legs crossed.
Yeah, you keep your legs crossed, yeah?
Battleborn, go sit on the end of the bed Indian style so we can see what it looks like.
Demonstrate, huh?
Yeah, now we have to see it.
Well, she's the only person that has anything to demonstrate on.
Goes like this, like demonstrate, you know? Did you see it? Banner?
No. I don't see it.
Well, it does help with my banner just covering, but...
Yeah, you might have to go back a little bit.
Yeah, scoot back in toward the headboard.
Yeah.
The black is blending too much.
Yeah. You know what it is? Actually, can you move to your right a little bit? I'm telling you. Oh, your other right. Sorry, to the left.
This is weird.
Yeah, he meant
actually, you know what? The right was better. You should move back to the right.
I think he's enjoying this a little too much.
I'm just messing with you. I'm sorry.
Okay, if you really don't know, just you know, go and Google it and see.
No, I know what it is. It's called sitting with your legs crossed. That's it. I've never heard of it being called. What would you call it again?
Indian crossing. Style?
Yeah, I've never been. I have no idea what that is. That's so weird. You Americans are weird. All of y'all.
Hey, Nation, to answer your question pertaining to hockey, it's because there are very few indoor skating rinks here, and everybody down here pretty much cares about football and NASCAR.
Fucking NASCAR, the left turn. I love it.
Well, see, here's my whole thing on NASCAR. It's cool that they're doing nearly 300 miles an hour in some cases, but the only part of talent in any of that is that they're doing it inches from each other. Other than that, there is no complexity to going in a circle.
You know what my favorite part of NASCAR is?
The crashes.
The left turn! Sorry, I had to. NASCAR is fun to watch for like 30 seconds. And then it's like, alright. Enough of it.
Yeah, well, pretty much, like, when NASCAR races start, you know, because, like, some of them are, like, 200, 300 laps,
yeah.
The best time to tune in if you want to watch it is going to be, like, the last 10 to 12 laps, because that's when everybody's going to start bumping into each other and causing shit to crash.
Yeah. I was going to say, like, the first, 15 minutes and the last 15 minutes, that's all you need to see.
Exactly.
So, yeah, what's, what are, I don't even know how to, like, are you guys, like, all baseball fans? And, like, is it all football, I guess, in the South? What would it be?
I mean, like, most people down here, yeah, like, a lot of people down here watch football religiously. I mean, I watch football, like, I understand what's going on, but I really don't, I could care less. Like, I'm not really a professional sports person. I follow, like, motorsports and like that kind of thing. Most of the stuff that I like watching isn't even in this country.
Really? Well, I know Igor, I know you're from Michigan, right?
Yeah.
If I remember correctly. So you're on my page, you're all about hockey up there.
Oh, fuck yeah, they are here.
Yeah, I know, actually, we just got your coach this year.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, we got Babcock. This is hockey talk, they wouldn't understand. They're all like, what's a Babcock? Well, I'll tell you what a Babcock is. Right up there with that carpet cleaner.
I think it's funny that you still have Battleborn on screen share.
Oh, do I? I'm so sorry.
I thought something was wrong with me. I was like, no, he's still presenting.
I totally agree with that. Actually, you should show me that the presentation again.
No. You can go once you're done with
the can you move left? Can you move right? And she was doing it.
You know, just turn around and do it.
Yeah. Now twerk.
Twerk, twerk, twerk. No.
Yeah. Oh, man. I used to twerk. I used to twerk professionally.
Bullshit, do it.
You can't call bullshit on that.
No, you said video and it didn't happen.
My webcam did stop working.
For Chippendales and they told him no.
Yeah, it just stopped working. I don't know what happened. It's the weirdest thing. So K-Dub said he was coming back, but I haven't heard from him. He must have busted like 2 fucking mall rats.
Probably having to write a statement and fucking all that shit.
Yeah, you know that shit. So, Ehart, have you been riding lately or what?
No, I haven't, unfortunately. It's been cold, but then it did warm up, but then I've had my leg issue. Like, this weekend it's supposed to be in the 60s, and I'm like, oh my god, should I try it? Should I just try?
That sounds pretty warm to me.
But I was in so much pain, I can't say trying to go for a short ride is worth the pain, though, either.
Step back.
Yeah. I mean, it was to the point where I so much as tried to use the muscle in my leg at all whatsoever, and I would be screaming in excruciating pain.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it would even be worth it just even for a short ride.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, out of how much I want to, I'm kind of, like, already talking myself out of it, because what if it aggravates whatever the fuck is already aggravated? Like, it would not be worth it.
I damage it further. And
that's exactly. And it's, like, right where, like, way up high in your thigh, like, where your thigh attaches to the rest of your body.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I'm sorry to hear that. It sucks.
It does. So I'm thinking I'm probably going to sit the weekend out and just listen to all the bikes drive by.
Hey, Ehart, what did they actually put you on for your pain?
Flexerol. Well, they gave me a shot of Toradol at the hospital. And then they gave
Flexeril for the muscle relaxer?
Flexerol and that naproxen stuff.
Well, naproxen is just prescription strength ibuprofen, more or less. But with that Flexeril, make sure that you're staying hydrated.
Make sure what?
Make sure you're staying hydrated.
Oh, okay.
What's a hydrate?
Fluids.
Yeah, like mm-hmm. fluids.
Like fluids you'd have, like carpet cleaning fluids?
No. Like ragamuffin fluid.
Ragamuffin. Yeah, that's
lots of beer.
Yeah, you fucking ragamuffin. I said I was going to call people now. Like, instead of calling them, like, a name, it's going to be like, hey, you fucking ragamuffin. What the hell?
Or, like, if you see somebody wearing some stupid outfit that, like, nothing matches and they look ridiculous, be like, dude, you can't go out looking like a ragamuffin.
How do I look like a ragamuffin?
And then they're going to look at you like, is that good or bad?
That's fucking funny. Oh, man. Oh, what a random chat today.
Right? I'm laughing because there wasn't really that many things that people were putting up for the southern accent.
Oh, I can have some stuff.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
No, you still have to, okay, no, basically, you still have to, like, you still have to pick, like, a news headline for you to read and not, like, Southern Confederate kind of tone going on.
Oh, that's right. That's right. He was supposed to think of a news article. Well, hey, A-Nation, take and pull up something in like one of your other tabs or whatever, like for your local news, pull up one of the news articles and then screen share it and I'll read it.
Yeah, I'm going to do this right now. Actually, I was going to copy and paste them, but hey, hold on. Yeah, you guys talk about something and I'll do the other shit. That works.
Right.
I'm trying to see, I try to see one too and see how it goes.
Well, your accent options are either Deep South Confederate.
Bro, that's so funny. Okay, let me tell you something. Like, so the Google on my phone and the Google on my laptop, like I'm signed into the same account.
Yeah.
So I literally just searched something on my phone, and then when I went to search the exact same thing on my laptop, it automatically brought it up.
Dude, that shit's been happening lately. It's freaking.
Yeah, it's like they're linked. It's like it knew. It knew what I was talking about.
Well, yeah, that's because if you're like, cause you said you use an iPhone, right?
Yeah, it's all linked together or some shit.
Yeah. I mean, well, cause like I have an iPhone 5S, and then I've got the MacBook Pro. So like they're linked together. So whatever I do on one, I can immediately open in the other. Like, if I watch a video on YouTube on the computer and pause it halfway through and then go outside to have a cigarette and open YouTube on my phone, it automatically pops up to where I was and I can hit play and continue the video on my phone.
That's how my Mac is. And then it could do, same with text messages. So usually my Mac will pop up with the text messages before my phone actually gets it. Or yeah. I can surf the net, and if Mario's on my Mac here, he can see from my phone when I'm surfing on the net.
That might not be the best.
He'll start reading it. Like, I'll read an article, not porn, FYI. I'll read an article, and he'll be like, oh, you know, you can, he's like, he reads it off, and I'm like, the fuck? You know, because there's exactly what I read. I was like, the hell's going on? It's like Illuminati kind of shit going on, right?
Illuminati.
I tried a Christmas shop for him online.
So, it's this, so it's like, oh, how are you reading that? He's like, oh, I just put the app down here on your Mac, and that's what you're looking at right now. Like, fucking creepy. Like, literally.
But I just keep getting pictures. I'm trying to get like the text, but I just keep getting pictures for like funny news headlines.
Okay, well, Battleborn, you try to find something, because I don't really know what's going on in your state at the moment.
Oh, okay. Let me bring up one for you. Let's bring up.
You call it pop or soda?
What's down here?
It's a pop.
Yeah, pop or soda.
It's a pop.
Believe it or not, in the South, which basically means like South Carolina, Tennessee, Georgia, Alabama, and sometimes Louisiana, most of us down here, if you go to a restaurant to order a carbonated beverage, most people from the South will just be like, hey, let me get a Coke. And then the server will be like, okay, well, what do you want? And, you know, because, like, down here in the South, everything that's carbonated is called a Coke. It's stupid, but it's true.
Yeah, that's what I've heard. It's called a Coke. But I always, like, if I order drinks over here, it's like, what kind of soft drinks do you have? That's just me, though. Do you have Coke or Pepsi? Like Wheeler works for me. So.
Yeah, well, see, and that's what I do, too, is, like, just from, I guess, not really being a true Southerner and then also living in Oregon for 2 years, I usually just... Whenever they come over and ask me what do I want to drink, I ask them what they have. And that way they have to list it, so I just call it whatever they call it.
That's funny.
I don't know. There's right now it's currently it's starting to snow in Reno, so that's one of the snowing articles right now.
All right, here, I got one for you. Hold on, here. I'm screen sharing it now. Ready? So here.
There you go.
There you go.
Okay, there you go.
So read this one.
Okay. Well, you have to keep it on screen, yeah?
Oh, am I not presenting? Hold on, sorry.
Well, you were, but then it kept going off.
That's weird. I don't know how to internet.
Well, stay right there. Don't touch anything.
That's what she said.
Is Alton a city?
I have no idea. This isn't like local to me. This is just Google.
Alton City attorney accidentally sues himself.
Oh, man. Keep going. Just keep going.
All right, here. Pull that one back up.
Oh, damn it. How am I not? What the? What in the hell?
What the Sam hell?
Is it still sharing or no?
Kind of. It's going back and forth.
Is it only when I'm talking?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Hold on. Let me see if I can click it on my screen to make it do something.
Yeah, there you go. You just click me on my screen and then you'll get it. But I should be...
In local news tonight, a man was paralyzed by choking on a pork chop.
Oh, this is too funny. There you go.
Whoa.
For hiding weed, what?
In the rolls of fat.
Oh. Tonight, in other news, a 450-pound man arrested for hiding his weed in his fat rolls.
I don't know why that amuses me so much, but it does. Oh, man.
Well, according to Richard Lavalil, I should just talk the whole rest of this thing in this accent.
I think you should. I think it would be funny to see how long you could go.
It's actually probably going to be really hard because I'm trying not to laugh as it is.
All right, this one, I think this one's fucking hilarious right here.
Well, do it.
Okay, hold on. hang on, I'm trying to click on it and make it bring you up. Okay, there we go. Sadly, the best man at a wedding was left bleeding after being hit in the head by a flying dildo.
Wait, you'll read the rest. The bottom.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you gotta... And wait!
Wait until you hear what came from.
I think I'm presenting now to everybody. There you go. Okay, hold on. I got more.
Okay.
Federal agents raid local gun shop and found weapons. Who the fuck?
Well, I'll be damned.
How to declare? How did they expect to find weapons in a damn weapon store?
This is the Confederacy, goddammit.
Sadly, a local man was arrested after cops spot a suspiciously small package in his underwear.
A battleborn.
Hashtag micropenis.
Right?
Oh, man. This is too funny.
Great.
I'm going to get, like, banned from fucking YouTube for this. Oh, God.
Hang on. I can't even.
Oh. We're fucking dying.
YouTube for this. Oh, God.
Today, on local highway, condom truck tips over, spills load.
Oh, man.
That's funny.
It was too fucking funny, man.
Here, on the next one, wait, hang on.
What the fuck is this one? I don't want that one. That one seems fucking morbid.
Here, hang on. Keep your screen still for a second. In the related images, click on the one that's the bottom row, second from the left.
The second from the left?
Yeah, second one from the left. Yeah, that
right
one.
Here?
And then hit view image.
Oh, my goodness. My internet's not working. All right, there you go. Dude, if this takes me to porn, I swear to God.
Don't worry, I didn't hack your. I didn't. Oh well, damn it. Never mind. Back out of that, because it's not going to show you the right thing. I was trying to enlarge it so that I could actually read the article.
Look what you did. You want what? This one, right?
Yeah.
Oh wow.
Yeah, that's way too much. You just read that one.
Well, no, I was going to read it in the accent. That way, it was like a news broadcaster.
We got, who do we got in the chat here? Mr. Joshua.
Yes.
Is this who I think it is?
The Big Bukowski.
There we go, Big Bukowski. Yes. What's going on, buddy?
Oh, hey, thanks for the go, bro.
Typical Thursday night, right?
Tentacle porns? What?
Typical Thursday night.
Oh, I thought you said something much different than that.
Well, now we know what you're into.
Well, yeah, based on the comments, I can see how you might think that.
Well, no, we're talking about what A Nation was into.
You have no idea what I'm into, bro. I'm into all sorts of, what was it, rag muffs and carpet cleaning?
Ragamuffin, carpet cleaning.
Ragamuffin? Damn ragamuffins. How about this one here? Hold on. Where is it? I can't find it. Dude, I need to hear this one in an accent so badly right now.
Which one?
I just, hold on.
Oh, you gotta scroll back over.
No, you don't worry about what I'm doing.
No, I can't see what you're trying to get me to read.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to find it myself.
Oh.
Trying to find a new image.
Well, damn it, man. I didn't know you was having all sorts of them kind of troubles.
Yeah, there we go. There it is.
Oh, God.
Wait, what happened? Yeah, there it is. Right there.
Oh, God.
Tonight, we cover a tragedy in Mexico. Two midget wrestlers killed by hookers. Poor little fellas.
Can we try and do that in, like, a different accent? Like, I'll try that in Jamaican.
I can't do Jamaican, but like, I can do, like, the BBC news.
Like, oh, my God. Yeah, man. Come on, wrestlers killed by hookers, man. Boom, McLatt.
He can't do it because he's like laughing his ass
off. Fucking dying.
We need an Australian.
So wait. Two midget wrestlers. So like, did two midgets hire one hooker, or was it multiple?
Well, no. There's an S on hooker, so they at least got two.
Yeah, they at least got two on there. There's plural there.
Oh, like, oh, I can't even right now. This is too fucking fun. Oh, what's this? That sounds like the American way right there. This is,
well,
another message brought to you by the Confederacy.
Are you being bullied at your local school? Well, the teachers advise you to just act less gay, because we don't like your kind around these parts.
Don't like midgets? Hire some hookers.
Oh, my God.
Today, in other news, being bullied, just act less gay, says teachers.
It was too fucking much, man.
Well, those headlines.
I have family from the South. I mean, that's originally where my family's from. And
I've lived in Georgia my entire life.
I'm pretty used to the accent, but it's messed up because my uncle, I cannot understand shit he says. I look at his wife and I'm just like, what'd he say?
Even though her accent is really fast.
Kind of, yeah, but it's almost like he's not even finishing his words, and I'm just like, what did he say?
That's, I know what you're talking about, and that's actually, like, the really, really, like, I mean, well, I don't want to sound disrespectful to your family, but that's kind of, like, the backwoods accent around, like, where I'm from, because the town I live in only has a population of, like, 780 people.
I know Battle Board's reading these right now, so I'm just...
Oh, I am.
Yeah, I'm just going off on your facial expression. Like, I feel like every single one of these articles are from the States.
Well, wait. That one you were just on actually had the state at the top of it.
Which one? This one?
No. Nope. Up.
This one?
Nope.
To the left.
That one. This, yeah.
One?
Nope. First
this one?
One. Yeah, that one.
Oh, that one. Okay.
Click on it.
I'm on it.
No, the one with the sewer one.
The unsure.
Yeah.
South Haven.
Yeah, the city of South Haven, wherever that's at. I'm sure in the States there's probably
South Haven. Unsure why are there sewer smells. This, I like this one. This one's fucking funny. She was alive.
Quack.
course. God damn it! Didn't you know she was alive before she died, man?
If you want to hear some hilarious headlines...
Diana was still alive hours before she died.
Oh, my God.
If you want to see some hilarious headlines, watch ETC News Weekly Weird News that they put out every week. Yeah, it's ETC or Machinima on YouTube.
Yeah?
Oh, my
God. Post it in the chat. I don't know about this one. I don't agree with this one.
Okay, do you want that one done?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Tonight, we have a close look at the dating circuit. Finds that men choose attractive women. I wouldn't suppose they'd select unattractive women.
Oh, man. Okay, I'm done with this. This is too funny. That's good. Too funny, though. Oh, man. Too much fun. We lost all our viewers now. That's okay. Screw them. Screw them all. The only person that matters is Will. I know Will's still watching.
Or at least listening.
Did you advertise on Instagram that you're on here?
Yeah, I think I did. Oh, we had a shit ton of followers before, or like a bunch of people watching. Then we started like goofing around and doing nonsense, and they all left. We were like, fuck that.
That's the entertaining part.
Exactly.
Well, see, that's the sad part, is that all the people left when we started dicking around, and that's kind of the whole point of a hangout, ain't it?
The accident.
Swear to the Confederacy.
I pledge to my Confederacy that I will abide by our nation's laws and support every individual in the war effort.
Too funny. Oh, shit. All right, guys, it's 11 o'clock, so we're going to cut this one now.
11?
Yeah, it's 11 for me. I don't know what time it is for you.
9 o'clock here.
Is it? Well, doesn't that just suck for you?
I just joined.
Well, we'll still kick it in the after-party live chat for a little bit, you know. But that's where all the private memories and secrets happen.
Right, that's where all the fun shit goes down.
Exactly. That's where all the racial slurs happen. That's courtesy of Battleborn, of course.
That's where all the shit happens that gets you kicked off a YouTube live stream.
Yeah, exactly. Actually, I've probably been kicked off a live stream. I just don't know it yet. Like, all right, you white trash.
Come to find out that, like, half of that stream was already blocked by YouTube.
Exactly. If you guys want to plug your channels real quick, and then we'll call it a night.
Unplug my channel.
Yeah, or if you don't have a channel, plug your Instagram.
Oh.
Advertise in side chat.
Yeah, exactly. So we'll start with Battleborn.
I'm Battleborn Rider. You can check me out on YouTube. And for Instagram, it's Kara_Anderson89.
Which is not her actual name, so don't even think that. That's just two random names she came up with, so...
Like a stage name.
Exactly. Yeehart, we'll go to you.
Check me out, Insta, or YouTube, Yeehart34.
You. Mr. The Big Lebowski?
The Big Borkowski. YouTube, I don't have a special extension. Because I don't have 500 subscribers yet, but
he does have some crazy midget porn. So
you can click on my name in the side chat, you'll bring it right there. And Instagram is still the Big Borkowski, just like it is.
There it is. Yeah, he likes all my photos. I like him.
I just found your Instagram to message you.
Exactly. Ninja Basics.
YouTube name is NinjaBasics87, and presently don't do any of the videos because my computer can't handle editing software. But if you have tech questions or want to find out how to fix or repair or modify anything on your bikes, shoot me a line on there, and I'll get with you.
And after today, he's also doing Southern Confederacy lessons.
Also, if you really want to watch a funny video that made me fall on my floor laughing at my own video is the vlog every day until Christmas video I just posted up today.
And apparently in the side chat, Will PH Moto has posted my link.
Yeah, he's good for that. All right, guys, I'm A Nation. You guys know where I'm at. You're already here, so fucking subscribe, like, do that shit. Check everybody out on this channel, and we'll talk to you guys later. Peace!
Cheers!